Is WAVE better than FLAC? And what about M4A? From time to time, the discussion about audio formats resurfaces. So let's clear things up again. Let me start by thanking viewers who support my channel. My remark about the financial support in my video I'm back and the QR code now on screen had its impact. While we're on the right track, we're still not close to minimum wage. So if you can spare €1, dollar, pound or equal per month, please use the QR code on the screen. This is a different code from the previous one, which turned out to be valid for only a limited period. Now, the question at hand. If you don't realize there's a difference between a codec and a wrapper, audio file formats can be quite confusing. So, what is a codec and what's a wrapper? And which files are lossless and which ones are not? The analog to digital converter, ADC, that outputs 16 or 24 bits audio simply provides the measurements, the samples, of the analog input signal in either 16 or 24 bits. To store these bits in a robust way and make them accessible to player software or hardware, they need to be formatted according to a given standard. That's the function of a codec. Codec stands for coder, decoder. Some codecs are uncompressed, others use compression, either lossless or lossy. Uncompressed codecs simply add an identifier, file size, file format, sampling frequency, bit depth, and some other information. Lossless codecs take the audio data and apply compression comparable to zip files for computers. Just like an unzipped spreadsheet is identical to the original, reversing audio lossless compression restores the file exactly as it was. Depending on the settings, the file size can be reduced to about 60-65% of the original. The main difference in settings usually relates to the processing power needed for decompression. Not much of an issue with modern equipment. Lossless codecs, on the other hand, can compress audio files to less than 10% of the original size, but at the expense of audio quality. If the audio data is the text of a letter and the codec is the language in which it is written, the wrapper is the envelope. Envelopes come in all shapes and sizes, with windows, without windows, padded, plain, etc. They might reveal the sender and recipient, but usually only give limited hints about the content. In 1988, Electronic Arts introduced the Interchange File Format, IFF, used on Amiga computers. Apple later developed AIFF, an audio wrapper based on IFF, with the .AIF or .AIFF extension. Today, Apple uses the MP4 wrapper with the M4A extension. In 1991, IBM and Microsoft introduced the WAVE format, which uses the .WAVE extension. Both AIFF and WAVE can contain audio encoded with a wide variety of codecs, although today WAVE files typically contain lossless linear pulse code modulation, linear PCM for short. Technically, however, they can also hold IEEE floating point PCM lossless or lossy codecs, such as ADPCM, MicroLAW, ALAW, WaveBack, GSM 6.10, MP3, DTS, Dolby Digital, and others. The same goes for AIFF. It sports many lossless and lossy codecs, although the list differs slightly from WAVE. Apple now primarily used MP4 wrapper with the .M4A extension for audio. This can contain linear PCM, lossless IEEE floating point PCM, or a lossy codec. Most often it will hold either Apple Lossless Audio Codec, ALAC for short, or the lossy Advanced Audio Codec, abbreviated to AAC. This is where things get different. The MP3 codec was developed by the German Fraunhofer Institute and appears in the first and second generation MPEG standards. It uses an MPEG-2 file format, but has the MP3 extension as its specifications are found in MPEG-2.5 Audio Layer 3. MPEG-3 always uses the same codec. The difference in audio quality depends on the settings chosen during encoding. There's a trade-off between sound quality and file size. For music, bitrates between 128 and 320 kilobits per second are common. A variable bitrate, VBR for short, can also be used, adjusting the bitrate depending on the complexity of the music. When Apple started streaming music, they used the MPEG-4 Advanced Audio Codec, AAC, which is the audio component of the MPEG-4 Advanced Video Codec High Definition, AVC HD, also known as H.264. AAC is superior to MP3, achieving equal sound quality at about half the bitrate. Apple initially applied its own copy protection to AAC files, leading many to think AAC was an Apple-owned format, which it is not. As with MP3, the compression rate is chosen during encoding. More compression yields smaller files, but lower sound quality. AAC typically uses the .m4a extension. The free lossless audio codec, FLAC, uses the .flac extension and, as the name implies, is lossless. On playback, the DAC sees the same bits as it would with lossless WAV files, but the data must first be decoded back to linear PCM. Some players have trouble decoding FLAC files, often due to limited processing power or power supply issues. Both the codec and the wrapper are unique to FLAC, so you always know it's using the FLAC lossless compression method. Sampling rates can theoretically range from 1 Hz to 655,350 Hz, though in practice they are usually 44.1, 44.8 or multiples thereof up to 384 kHz. Since I summed up almost all file types used in audio today, let's make it complete by mentioning DirectStream Digital, DSD for short. It is the encoding method used for Super Audio CDs. It uses 1-bit Delta Sigma modulation at a very high sampling rate. There are two codecs, .dsd-iff, DirectStream Digital Interchange file format, which is uncompressed, and .dst, Digital Stream Transfer, which uses lossless compression. There are also two wrappers, .dff, which is a .dsd-iff file that can contain stereo or 5.1 surround, but no metadata. .dsf, which is stereo only, but has space for metadata. There's often debate about the supposed sound quality difference between FLAC and WAVE. While the output to the DAC should be identical, some people claim to hear differences in favor of WAVE. When comparing file formats, it's essential to use the same audio file. It also applies to comparing CD and streaming. There are often multiple versions of a track online, remastered, level adjusted, etc. To compare, rip a CD using software that performs checksum verification, such as Exact Audio Copy, EAC. Rip to both formats you want to compare, WAVE and FLAC. Then compare them by ear. For tips on what music to use, see my video What Albums Do I Use for Testing and How Do I Do Listening Tests. Links to the videos are in the description, in the top right corner of the screen, and at the end of this video. I suppose you want to know my judgment now. I have compared wave and flag on several occasions and did a comparison again for this video. I use setup 1 for this test. The amp was the Air Acoustics AX520 connected to the PMC FAC12 signature loudspeakers on Stack Audio Ova 17 isolators and connected over AudioQuest Robinhood Zero loudspeaker cables. The PSI Audio AVAA active bass trap improved the low end. The small green computer Sonic Transporter i7 CDR runs Rune Server and holds my own RIPS and is connected to Tidal and Cobus. It was connected to the network players over the Zixel GS1900-10HP switch. The first network player was the combination of the Magna Mano Ultra MK3.5F streamer running Gentoo player connected via I2S over a short Tuoso HDMI cable to the Holo Audio Cyan 2 DAC and a hybrid EAL2000 Ethernet filter. The second was the Mytek Brooklyn Bridge 2 and the third the Grim Audio Mu 2. Analog connections were the Grim Audio SQM XLR cables. I used a classical symphonic recording, a jazz recording and a rock recording. All three were freshly ripped to both wave and flak. I know it's very boring, but even after long listening, I couldn't hear any difference. Of course, there was a difference between players, but not between wave and flak. I may have bored you with too many details you weren't expecting, but understanding how things work can bring more listening pleasure and less frustration. But I will torture you no longer since we're at the end of this video. A new video is coming soon, so don't forget to subscribe or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or TikTok. Patreon and YouTube Premium members get early access and no ads. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it. It really helps. A huge thank you to everyone who supports the channel financially. You keep me independent and that means a lot. Even 1 euro, pound or dollar makes a difference. Use the QR code on screen or the links in the description to contribute. I'm Hans Beekhuizen. Thank you for watching and whatever you do, enjoy the music.